see.
What?
It's just nothing more.
Who says so, your parent?
No. I'm saying so. I just need more from a relationship.
How much? I give you all the love and attention I can get.
Right now, that's not enough. My parents would also like to know what you do, excuse me, for a living. Come to that, so would I.
Well, I've already told you. I get by.
But you don't seem to be getting by at the moment. You spend your time hiding from so many people. Who are they, Guy?
Who's who?
The people you won't answer the door to.
Your father's a rich man.
Yeah, so what?
Well, you get rich by being busy. And being busy means that you don't have to open the door or answer the phone. Unless you really have to. Fancy some lunch?
Yes.
It means I have to get a menu.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Buchanan.
Who?
It's my responsibility to give this to you.
Thank you. It's my responsibility not to accept it. Sorry about the gin situation.
Oh, that's all right.
It's just that the off-license hasn't delivered, and the same problem with the grocer. That's the trouble with the present generation of shopkeepers. They're a bunch of managers and fly-by-nighters. I may have to take my custom elsewhere. Look, if you're desperate for a gin and tonic...
No.
Well, we could go out. I mean, we could drive somewhere.
How do we get to your car?
We walk, of course.
It is crazy. Why do you always park your car several streets away from your own front door?
I've told you before. Security.
But is it your car?
Not quite.
Then whose car is it?
Belongs to a leasing company.
You can be so sweet sometimes.
Hmm?
I'm so lost.
Lost?
Yes. Guy, what would you do if I left you?
I'd jump under a bus. You are joking, I hope. Because I need you, Joe. Age difference or not. And I promise that one day I will tell you all about my wicked past.
When?
Soon.
That may be too late. Whoever you are, you've got to help.
I think you would be wise to accept this, Mr. Buchanan.
Thank you, no.
I'm sure you'll find it to your advantage.
Listen, at this precise moment, there is nothing in the world that would be to my advantage.
At least open it, look at the contents, see what you could be missing.
I tell you what, you open it. Tell me what I'm missing.
All right, Mr. Buchanan.
If that's your wish. your initial expenses of £300 plus your invitation.
What invitation?
To the Bellinger Hotel.
What?
Torrington-on-Sea.
Thank you.
It's a pleasure. An RSVP won't be necessary.
Joe?
Hello, Mr. Bonifant. Rent? You mean you haven't received it? That's very odd. I put a check in the post 2 days ago. That's the last two quarters. No, right, bang up to date. No, no, that's all right. It's no trouble.
Speak to your daughter, Jo. No, she's not. You've no idea. No. Thank you very much, Mr. Perry. Goodbye.
About it, in 4 years' time, she'll be 30.
And what'll you be in 4 years' time? Pity past it. You won't know a percher from a panhandler.
I'll never be that past it.
Times are bad for people like us right now. But what's it going to be like in a few years' time? There's none of us getting any younger. But this girl... Joe, what was the attraction?
Well, at first it was the money.
Her money?
No, her father's money. And then, well... I just fell in love with her.
Men, the old-time con merchants, the professionals. Today's puncher, a lot of wide boys.
But who cares where they've gone?
I care.
What you mean is you need competition.
Competition's never bothered me. No, no, I was thinking about what you said earlier. About the future.
Oh, yeah, the future.
What do we do? Where do we go? What happens to us? There's no retirement home, you know.
No.
No pension.
No plump wife to bake his bread and provide us with a warm fire when we reach old age.
No. Point is, I'm in trouble, right? I'm skinned. I'm broke. Apart from 300 quid cash, I am stone cold. Brassic.
Where did you get the 300 quid?
It was a donation.
Oh.
Same again, please. You know, I had the weirdest invitation this morning.
Really?
Hmm. A chap in a 400-pound suit looked like a chucker out at a hunt ball.
Oh, thank you.
That's What I wanted to ask you, whether you'd look after my flat for a couple of days. I mean, there are one or two people I want to keep at bay, and you're very good at that.
Well, you have a free holiday.
Well, thank you. It's going to be a working holiday, I hope. I need to get away, and I need to score. I mean, hotel by the sea could be the ideal situation.
Well, I'm sorry I can't help you.
What do you mean you can't help me? You've got to help me.
I've made other arrangements.
What other arrangements?
I've packed my bag. I've arranged a parrot-sitter. You see, I've also received one of your weird invitations to the same place. I'm coming with you.
God, you're this far behind on your car payments.
Yes. Want to make a contribution for the petrol?
Oh, yeah.
Here we are.
Torrington-on-Sea. What do you know about it?
Nothing.
What about the hotel?
What about it?
You mean you haven't checked up on it?
I've been busy. And I've got a broken heart, remember?
Bellinger Hotel. Set majestically on the main marine parade, the Bellinger is a dignified hotel that recognizes the importance of both discretion and personal service. Doesn't it worry you that whoever's invited us hasn't put their name on the card?
Yes, it had crossed my mind. How far is Torrington-on-Sea?
At least 200 miles.
What? Well, that means we won't get there until the middle of the night. We aren't booked into the hotel until tomorrow.
That's okay, we can sleep on the beach.
Up, Buchanan. All your rich pickings are out here milling around and waiting for you.
Oh, I feel terrible.
Sea air is good for you. Anyway, at this stage of your life, you should get used to sleeping rough.
No, I couldn't. I couldn't live like this. Cleaned up.
Let's find that hotel. Set majestically by the sea in all its glory.
Glory? I won't find much glory in a place like this.
Back what I said.
Yeah, it's very beautiful.
Well, it could do with a bit of updating, maybe. Outdoor swimming pool, tennis court.
You know, Buchanan, you can be so home county sometimes. This is old-style grandeur. But you English can never see that. You have to make things tidy, feel obliged to mow grass and put up painted fences. What's up?
I know those two people. I thought they were dead.
Can I help you, madam?
Yes, we have a reservation, I believe.
This is like stepping back in time. You won't get a jacuzzi or a sunbed in this place.
He is art. I met them once in the 60s. They were old then. But in a class of their own.
Thank you.
We're doing what?
Pioneers in computer hacking.
Can I help you, sir?
Oh, yes. My name's Buchanan. This is Mr. Cassidy. I believe we have a weekend reservation.
Excuse me, sir. I'll just check. Yes, sir. Rooms 14 and 21. On the first floor.
Just as a matter of interest, our reservations, who exactly made them for us?
Well, Mr. Prager, of course, sir.
Is he around? It's just We'd love to talk to him.
Oh, I've no doubt Mr. Prager will contact you, sir, when all of his other guests have arrived.
His other guests?
Yes, sir. Welcome to Torrington on Sea.
Does it mean anything to you?
No.
Me neither. And you know something? Right now, my instinct tells me to be very, very cautious. Suspicious, even.
What does that indicate?
Paranoia.
Yeah, and with just cause. I mean, why exactly are we here?
Well, I expect we'll soon find out.
Because that Mr. Prager, whoever he is, has obviously gone to a lot of trouble to find out about us.
Oh, yeah.
So how much actually does he know?
Harry, I have just escaped from a temporary poverty trap.
Of your own making.
I intend to take full advantage of any free hospitality going. Now, come on, get cleaned up. Let's take a look around. You've seen the place and the people in it. We've got it made here.
Yeah? Oh, yeah, yeah, I know. It may be out of date, but at least it's expensive. So are the guests, by the looks of things. The average age seems to be about 70.
Harry. Sitting ducks.
To be with us this weekend? Haven't you heard? He died.
Oh,
no.
When?
Early in the new year.
Did Lambert leave much? Not a great deal. Considering?
Not more than 400,000.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Are you fond of a game of cards?
Well, I have been known to play in the past, yes, but only for money, you understand.
Would you care to find the lady?
The three-card trick at your age? I'm ashamed of you.
For money, you said.
Yes.
Lambert was wise. Invested his money.
Such a talent.
Walked the check on most of the big hotels in Europe.
Good penman as well.
I could never fake paper the way he could.
Well, his wife's going to Nestle, isn't she? It was never well enough.
Remember that time we were in Brazil?
Never.
We sold them nuts instead of cotton.
To me.
Now what?
This old lady, old enough to be me grandmother, just did a party on me.
What threw you into the three-card game?
Yeah, and I fell for it. She worked it like a top-rate boardsman. Didn't even see her switch the queen. And she did it alone without a dog eye or a plant to help her.
How much did you lose?
55 quid. Could have been worse only if I had the good sense to chicken out. And not only that, when I was getting out of the lift, this old guy with a gammy leg comes up to me and starts to put down a routine. He shows me sheets of Doth share prices. He had me picked out as a mark. This place is full of fraudsters.
I know. I've just discovered that.
Mr. Cassidy and Mr. Buchanan.
So pleased you could make it.
Oh, it's a pleasure.
The other guests at this hotel, who are they?
Old friends and colleagues of Mr. Prager. You'll have a chance to meet them at the reunion dinner party this evening.
I've already met some of them. You see, we're not old friends and colleagues of your employer.
No.
So why have we been invited?
Mr. Prager would like you to assist him.
Doing what?
He's having a rest now after his swim. He likes to take a swim at least once a day. He's told me that he would like to introduce himself before the get-together this evening. May I suggest a short, brisk walk this afternoon? Along the promenade at Shilling Beach.
Ever been to Torrington on the Sea before?
No.
No, never. Oh, it's a charming place.
There's a nip in the air, Mr. Prager. You'll need this.
Oh, thank you. Mr. Cassidy and I are independent business associates. Management consultants. And whilst we're enjoying your hospitality, perhaps you could have contacted us through normal working channels.
With respect, Mr. Buchanan, you and Mr. Cassidy are no more management consultants than I am a blacksmith. So don't just attempt to fool each other, eh? But by nature, we can't. We're all con men. I represent the past, you two the present. But all three of us can have an important part to play in future events.
In what way?
By working together.
How did you get to hear about it?
By having you watched.
Mr. Prager, it's getting much colder. I think we should go back soon.
Well, I, for one, I'm not too keen about being spied upon.
Even though it may be to your advantage?
Even then.
You're going through a bad patch, Mr. Cassidy, and you know it. And your situation isn't much better. In fact, it's probably worse. Lack of good opportunity has brought you to this sorry state. Wouldn't you agree?
Possibly.
A lack of health and the passing years have led to mine. But together, we can put that right under my guidance. You see, this could be the one big break you've always pitched for. This could make you rich. Sorry that some of our old friends and confederates can't be with us on this happy occasion. Sadly, some are dead, some are sick, and some, despite their advancing years, have found themselves being entertained in less happy surroundings, by courtesy of Her Majesty's government. But perhaps they've only themselves to blame. Because as you know, the golden rule at our age is, if you can't do the time, don't do the crime. Well, I hope you all enjoy yourselves here this weekend. You know as well as I do, the best credit in the world is other people's money. But on this occasion, it's all on me. And I feel deeply honored. I toast you all and absent friends.
met in 1969.
Huh?
We met in 1969.
Oh, we did?
You won't remember.
Yes, at the Dolls Club.
Oh.
I expect you're retired.
No, who needs to retire?
We discovered first copy video piracy. Volume selling. Or rather, I did. He's still the mechanic. Excuse us. Shall we dance?
Would you like to dance?
Yes.
Care for a couple of hands of poker later?
Thanks. I'll let you know.
I lived in Eastern Europe for a great many years.
Oh, really?
But I left. There were too many third-rate imposters there.
Imposters?
Yes. What's your name?
Guy.
I'm Anastasia. Thank you.
What that fellow Prager had to say to us. Do we like the sound of it?
I don't really know yet. What about you?
I'm really just not sure.
I hope you're enjoying yourself.
Oh, yes. Yes, we are.
Yes, just great.
Good. Mr. Prager would like to talk business now.
My one real game is, and always will be, snowball financing.
Corporate crime?
Yeah.
On a big scale?
In my case, on a grand scale. I worked it quite successfully during the late 50s and on into the 60s. The economic climate was ideal then, and now the climate is right again. For us.
So what do we do?
First, we set up our own building society. Over the next year or so, we incorporate other outfits, land allotment companies and the like. Eventually, we open our own bank. Now, with these companies, we buy and sell land and properties to each other, keeping competitors out. The profits can be huge, our profits. No one else's.
And the money to finance these companies?
It'll come from subscriptions. Now, all we have to do is to make the small investor believe in us early on in the proceedings. So each quarter, we give him a big interest on his savings.
Interest in writing?
Of course. Never in cash. Now, with their cash, we float each new company. By tempting shareholders with the bait of success, we become oversubscribed, which is always a good thing. The more subscriptions, the better. Those shareholders will want to be part of that success. They'll revel in it.
Won't they realize that their dividends are being paid out of new subscriptions and not company profits?
Well, they need never know.
Our job is to keep the snowball rolling.
Yeah.
Snowballs melt.
This one won't.
If it is, as you say, your game, why do you need us?
During the 50s and 60s, I worked closely with two colleagues. We were the perfect team, but completely dependent on each other. Each of us had the knowledge to make the fraud work. And unfortunately, they're no longer with me.
Where are they?
Well, Johnson's now nearly 80, in a geriatric hospital. And Khan is somewhat younger. He's in a private nursing home.
Where?
Quite near here. That's the reason for holding this little celebration at Turrington-on-Sea. I want you to visit these men.
Visit them?
Yeah. Mr. Tigg will give you the necessary details. I want you to talk to them. Listen to them. Pick what's left of their brains. I want you to be them. They're the best of their kind. And that knowledge must not be allowed to rot with them. Bring that knowledge back here. Learn it. All of it. Then we'll have a team again. A team to be reckoned with.
I think it's time for your rest now.
Yes, Mrs. Treason. See the problem? My mind is still perfect, but my body isn't. But together we'll change all that, won't we?
This isn't our game, Buchanan.
No, but it could be.
No. This man was a success, Harry. He still is. I mean, you've only got to look at him, talk to him to know that. We could be part of that success. It's the natural way of things. The old order dies and the new one takes over. We could be that new order.
Corporate crime at that level is big crime. And if we get caught, it means a big prison sentence each.
Listen to me, Harry. I need something good. I want to get it right just once before it's too late. Because I don't want to end up like those people downstairs tonight. Perhaps it's just that I want to park outside my own front door again. Pay my bills. Maybe even get Joe back. I need this break, Harry. I mean, what have we got to return to, eh? Nothing. My debts and your tatty flat.
I like my tatty flat.
What, when are you going to have this? Good hotels? Better hotels. Money to spend, perhaps for life, Harry.
I mean, you know yourself how difficult it is these days to find a really good mark. It's all a question of diminishing returns.
But these men, Johnson and Khan, what if they won't talk to us?
They've got to talk to us. I mean, it's their responsibility to talk to us. Prager's right. I mean, all that specialist knowledge is just wasting away. It belongs to us. It's our inheritance.
Oh, is that what it is? Yeah, all right. We'll see these people tomorrow, and then we can work things out from there.
Thanks.
But I'm only going to give it the one shot until I find out more. A lot more.
Right. Good night.
Sweet dreams.
Cassidy.
Do you mind if I sit here?
Not at all.
They do a nice kipper here. And fish is very good for a hangover.
I don't have a hangover.
Good. I'm glad to hear it.
Because I always make sure these days never to get so drunk that I don't know what I'm doing.
Very wise.
Have you been with Mr. Prager long?
Oh, yes. He and I go back a long way together. And he's a clever man. You and Mr. Buchanan are very lucky to have been given his patronage.
Just a pot of coffee, thanks.
Is something troubling you? You don't seem to be exactly overjoyed with your prospects.
Well, let's just say I'm cautiously optimistic. Always have been.
Mr. Buchanan seems happy enough.
That's because he's easier to please.
Oh. Mr. Johnson is in the Faraday Cottage Hospital. The visiting hours are fairly flexible. I've written them down for you. Mr. Kahn is living at the Cliff View Nursing Home. He can be visited any time of the day.
Fine. Thanks. Apart from the promise of being rich, what else do we gain once we've learned all there is to learn from these men?
You'll be part of Mr. Prager's business empire.
You mean he'll own us?
What's wrong with that?
What if Mr. Johnson and Mr. Kahn decide not to tell us anything? What happens then?
Then? I'm afraid there'll be no deal. You go back to where you came from, which was nowhere. Good morning.
Good morning. Morning, madam.
Morning. I'm going to church. I'll be about an hour there, but she's asking.
Okay. Nice morning.
Yes, it is.
Could I possibly have a word with you?
No, I'm sorry. I'm late for church. That is.
Alas, I've been late for it for years. Well, I won't keep you. It's just that, as a possible future member of the Prager workforce, I've decided to find out a little bit about the team I'll be working with.
Find out about us?
Yes. Get to know you all.
Well, how can I help? I'm only his nurse.
Well, that means you can vouch for his health, doesn't it? Because as an interested party, I'd like to be sure he's got a good few years ahead of him.
What?
Well, you do have a very important role to play. Mrs. Freestone, a life and death role, if you like.
If you're questioning my integrity, Mr. Cassidy, please don't bother. I've been a professional nurse for most of my working life.
I'm sure I'd be the last.
In the county hospital, in the nursing home service, and now with him. Of course, if you don't believe me, you can check it up.
No, thanks. There's been too much checking up going on already for my liking. So, what do you think of Mr. Prager?
What do I think of him?
Yeah, as a person.
He's a good employer.
What about his past?
I believe he ruined a lot of people a long time ago.
But that was a long time ago.
Exactly.
Well then, any words of advice?
Yes. Don't trust him.
You can drop me off at the Cottage Hospital. It's only the other side of town. And you can drive on out to this place. I'll find my own way back.
You've always been a good listener, Harry.
Have I?
Don't miss out on this one. We need all the knowledge we can get.
The public like ventures, you see. Ventures on a grand scale. Never try to sell them anything small, because they're prepared to pour their money into ventures. They always have, and they always will. The important thing is to think big. Now, that's what you've got to do. Think big. Always think big. The mugs won't respect you if you think small. Now, Sam Prager and Jim Johnson and I, we always thought big before we ever set pen to paper. Then it was up to me to produce the venture.
Ah, you were the ideas man.
Yeah. How is Sam?
Sam? Oh, Mr. Prager, he's fine.
Good. That's good.
He said that you were going to tell me more. A great deal more.
Who did?
Sam.
Yes, but it's Sunday.
Sunday?
Yes.
But what's that got to do with it?
Now, you come back tomorrow. Now, you bring a notepad with you tomorrow, and I'll tell you all you need to know tomorrow.
But why not now?
Because it's Sunday, not Monday. I always sleep all day on Sunday.
Mm.
Lansdowne would.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're a relative.
No, I'm just a friend. Why?
Well, I'm afraid Mr. Johnson died suddenly.
When?
The day before yesterday.
Why? Was he ill?
He was very old.
But was he ill?
No, he was quite well for his age.
Well, then, why should he die?
Because death from natural causes is to be expected at his time of life.
How did he die?
I just told you, natural causes. He suffered a failure of the respiratory system.
What time of the day was this?
He was found not long after visiting time. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Did Mr. Johnson have a visitor that day, do you know?
I believe so, yes.
Who?
I don't know. I wasn't on duty that day. Come back tomorrow and ask them. They'll tell you.
Asleep. Where's this great fountain of knowledge that we're supposed to be drinking from? Seems to be drying up.
Or somebody's been busy switching it off.
Well, at least one of them is still alive. I mean, this man Khan is okay, providing he stays awake. He can speak for both of them. We'll visit him tomorrow. Oh, sorry, would you like a drink?
No. Where's Prager?
I think that nurse of his is taken for his daily dip in the sea.
Come on, drink up. Let's get down there.
Huh?
For a swim.
Oh, not long. Anyway, it's never ever a real swim. Just a bit of a dip. Likes to get his knees wet, that's all. But he likes to think of it as a swim.
For how long has Mrs. Freestone been working with you?
A couple of years. She's a very good nurse. Knows her business. Also, like a mother to me. Always packs my favorite tipple. Hot rum and coffee.
What is going on, Kessler?
What sort of people have more or less free access to hospitals and nursing homes?
I don't know. Doctors, why?
And nurses.
Of course, nurses. I said, why?
I wonder what else went into that drink.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. Prager only likes to get his feet wet, why is he under the water? But why is she holding him down? Come on!
What's happened?
There's been an accident.
What do you mean an accident? We saw you holding him under the water.
Prove it. He was an old man and an evil one. All his talk, his boastings about the people he destroyed. You really think I'd let him and his friends get back together again with your help? My father lost everything to those men. I loved my father. He was a fine man, an honest man. He's also a victim. Their victim. Cost him his money, his sanity, his life.
So you waited to do this?
Yes. I killed Johnson 2 days ago. Khan this morning.